Hey there, I'm Josh Elledge, Chief Executive Angel at SavingsAngel.com, and welcome to the Savings Angel Show. I'm podcasting to you before heading off to shop for the holidays, some last-minute gifts here in Orlando, Florida. Now, I'm an extremely busy consumer expert, money-saving advocate, syndicated newspaper columnist, and that guy that turns digital entrepreneurs into media celebrities at UpMyInfluence.com. I love what I do and can't wait to get going on today's episode. So in order to help you save more, earn more, and live more abundantly on today's show, I'm going to be covering how to save mega, mega money with 2018 gift card deals. We're going to talk about how to build your credit with a little hookup that I found. Also, we're going to talk about how you can gain some financial freedom in 2019 and leave the corporate cubicle job. I found an industry that's trending right now big time, and I'm going to share how you can get a total hookup and begin that career shift into something more meaningful and more lucrative. So with that, let's get going. Now, the default gift for many giving occasions is a gift card. They're convenient, one size fits all, and most people are happy to receive them. Now, along with the ease of giving them, you can add another reason for buying gift cards: saving money. Now, here's how to save more money with 2018 gift card deals and tips. You ready? I got a bunch of the best deals that we have found on gift card promos and deals. I'm going to share this into some categories here. Okay. First off, restaurants. Numerous restaurants are offering promotions on their gift cards. Here's a short list of some of them. Now, there are dozens more. Guys, this is free money, like a lot of free money, like a lot of money that's like free that you wouldn't normally get. You can still use deals on top of this, but this is like just currency. You're getting 20% more currency if you pre-purchase what you would spend over the next several months or the next year or so. Okay. Applebee's, you get a $10 bonus with every $50 gift card bought. Cheesecake Factory, you get a free slice of cheesecake for every $25 gift card bought. Olive Garden, you get a $10 bonus for every $50 spent on gift cards. P.F. Chang's, you get a $20 bonus for every $100 gift card bought. Dunkin' Donuts, this one's really good. You get a $10 bonus for every $25 in gift cards bought. This is online only. So if you need the links to all this and all the other ones I am sharing with you, you go to savingsangel.com and you'll see the post that we just put together for all of these gift card hookups. We found, like I said, these are really like some of the best ones we found. This Dunkin' Donuts one, that's amazing, man. So make sure you follow our link and you go get that deal. Matter of fact, I'm going to open that in a window so I do not miss that one. Chili's, you get a $10 bonus for every $50 in gift cards bought. Now, you can also use promotional codes to save on gift cards. While promo codes are typically not valid on gift cards, sometimes they do work or are specifically for gift cards. Now, some that are valid on Amazon.com at the time of this podcast, I'm recording it right now, okay? We have a link to an iTunes gift card where you could buy a gift card worth $100 or more and save $15 with the code iTunes15, Dollar Shave Club. You could buy a gift card worth $50 or more and get $10 off with the code SHAVE10. Famous Footwear, you could buy a gift card worth $50 or more and save $10 with the code FOOT10. Rover.com, you could buy a gift card worth $50 or more and receive $10 off with the promo code DOG10. Again, I need you to remember, understand this, okay? You're getting a deal on the currency that you are going to be able to use in the future with additional savings, right? And I'm going to share how you can earn savings on top of savings here in just a second. But I want you to, I just want to make sure you remember that, right? Because you're getting a deal on the currency, then you're also getting more savings because, of course, you're going to use other coupon codes and take advantage of other sales on top of this. So you're going to earn gift cards by making purchases. Retailers such as Target offer gift card promotions on items throughout the year. Simply purchase from a specific group of items or category of products. Other retailers have been known to do similar things, such as Meijer Rewards, which are like a paper gift card for Meijer stores. Now, offers and items vary from gift card purchases to everyday items to small appliances, and they change continually. So you have to check back weekly for the deals. Next, Costco and Sam's Club. Now, both clubs have great deals on gift cards throughout the year. We just bought some for Regal Cinema, in fact, because movie pass just ain't like it used to be. So we got to go back to buying movie tickets. And our local BJ's offers a really good deal on Regal movie tickets. But anyway, this time of year, they have some even better promotions than normal. For example, at the time of me recording this, you can get four $25 Build-A-Bear gift cards for only $79.99 at Costco. Or at Sam's Club, you can get $100 in iTunes gift cards for just $79.47. That's a really good deal. I would not miss that iTunes deal. If you go through a lot of iTunes money, like you know someone that's got a little bit of a Candy Crush addiction, yeah, they could blow through $80 and over the course of hopefully it's more than a few months, but hopefully they're not spending that a week. Now, other denominations and savings are also available, so go check it out at Sam's Club. Now, these are just two of the many gift card deals that we found available at these club stores. Next, this is so important. You hear me talk about Swagbucks all the time. When you shop online, you watch videos, you take surveys, you search the internet, you find deals to earn points, and you can spend them on gift cards through Swagbucks. Guys, it's such a no-brainer. Just install the Swagbucks extension in your browser, and then you got a permanent hookup on everything that you're doing. You're just earning free money for doing stuff you're already doing. They also sell discounted gift cards. I never buy, well, I shouldn't say never, but I really try to avoid buying full price gift cards. There's just no need to, especially this time of year. But through Swagbucks, you can go there, swagbucks.com, sign up, and you can get started buying and earning. Now, here's three final tips I just want to make sure I share with you as we part this segment here. You can combine offers. Let me just sum this up for you. I've been telling you this several times now. Okay, here you do. You purchase a gift card at a discount or with a bonus. Then you use a discount code or coupon valid on your purchase, whether it's online or in-store, and pay with your gift card. Now, because gift cards are treated like cash, this works, and it's a great way for you to save up to 50%. If you're using Swagbucks, you get more savings on top of that. So if you shop online, again, also finally, don't forget to take advantage of free shipping. Now, second strategy here. Try that promo code on a gift card. Now, most of the time, promotional or discount codes won't work on gift cards, but occasionally they do. It's worth a try because sometimes you do find a retailer that is allowing the codes to work on their gift cards. And when you find one, let me know. Like, share that in our Facebook group so that you could pass along the savings. Now, the more you buy, it's my final tip, the more you save. With some offers, the more you buy, the better the bonus you receive. Team up with a friend to spend enough and share the extra savings. Are you ready for a new career? Is your current work undervalued and underpaid? Look, been there, done that. Do you lack fulfillment? If so, there's a trend that's been happening I've seen over the past year or so, and that's in the kind of the headhunter recruiting space. Look, you can make really good money in that space. Good friend of mine, Brianna Rooney, is the CEO and founder of techies.com. She created a course, and I'll explain it here in just a second, but she works very specifically in the technology sector. Technology is a multi-billion dollar industry, multi-billion dollar industry. And every day tech firms, startups are popping up all across the country, including, yeah, in your hometown or, you know, at least your next nearest big town. These tech firms need hardworking and talented software engineers to work for them. That's why there's such a high demand for tech recruiting right now. And it isn't showing any signs of slowing down. And in fact, in the next decade, the demand growth for tech roles is expected to explode. So can you position yourself in preparation for this continued growth? Well, the Millionaire Recruiter course, it provides all the know-how you need to launch your own successful business as a tech recruiter. Now, you can go back and you can listen to, I believe it was maybe episode 229, somewhere in there. Go back and just, you'll see it in the show description. I think it was around 229 or thereabouts. Go back and listen to my interview with Brianna. So you can hear her kind of explain it a little bit more, but I'll just tell you, that the Millionaire Recruiter course, it provides all the know-how you need to launch your own successful business as a tech recruiter or position yourself so that you can approach other existing tech recruiting agencies, show up, and on day one, you could be ready to earn some decent money. Now, even if you don't know the first thing about recruiting, it sounds confusing, sounds a little overwhelming. I have been through the course. I actually watched the videos. Brianna Rooney, like I said, is a good friend of mine. She's the CEO and founder of techies.com, which is the top tech recruiting firm in the San Francisco Bay Area. She designed the Millionaire Recruiter course to provide you with everything you need to know to succeed. So my recommendation would be go check out the Millionaire Recruiter course. You can go to savingsangel.com/recruiter. Okay, that's savingsangel.com/recruiter. You'll also, when you're on any page on savingsangel.com, just look on the right-hand side and look for the image where we talk about considering a career change. I interviewed people that are making six figures in their first year, believe it or not. You know, it takes a little bit of organization. You need to be organized. You need to be willing to learn how to use LinkedIn a little bit better. But, you know, Brianna will help you with that. And then certainly when you work with a good agency, they will also teach you, but it's really helpful if you want to get the job that you show them that you already have been through the basics. And that's what the Millionaire Recruiting course allows you to do. So once again, that's savingsangel.com/recruiter. If that doesn't work for you, go to savingsangel.com/millionaire recruiter. It's your choice. All right, Shane Walker, you're the Executive Vice President and Chief Marketing Officer with Proactive Budget, an app that I absolutely love. I think it is going to dominate the space. And I don't say that lightly. Can you kind of explain a little bit about what Proactive Budget is, how it works, and what makes it so unique and so much more effective than any other budgeting app that anyone may have used in the past?
Absolutely, Josh. The thing that's interesting about budgeting is it's very easy to create a budget and then not look at it through the month, do all your spending, and then at the end of the month, come and kind of reconcile your spending with your budget. And in most situations, that spending you've overspent, and it feels bad. It doesn't feel good to overspend, and you feel guilty. And so very few families stick to budgeting consistently. Yeah. In fact, Ryan Clark is my partner in this, and from our experience from the financial planning industry, we've met with hundreds of families, put them on many different budgeting platforms, and it's usually within 90 days that they've fallen off. And it's really frustrating because it's the basis to a financial plan. Budgeting is the basis. If you can control spending and you can control your money, then that provides a platform for us to build upon. And so what makes Proactive so special is it uses the cash envelope system, okay, which we believe is the most powerful budgeting platform in the world, because it really requires you to make a decision before you spend, to consult your budget each time before you spend. The problem with it is it's cash basis in a cashless world, and there's a lot of logistical problems with cash. Proactive Budget has really replicated the cash envelope system, made it cashless, and you can hold it in the palm of your hand, and it's always with you because it's on the phone. Okay, so each time you spend, you have to take certain steps that take seconds to consult your budget, activate that money so you can spend, and it always syncs with your budget. So in real time, you are experiencing what's going on with your budget and your spending simultaneously.
I love it. So, you know, from a human behavior standpoint, you know, I just having lost a lot of weight, I know that the one thing that absolutely worked for me is if I just leave it to chance and just say, oh, well, I'm going to try and eat healthy. I'm going to try and stay on a budget. And I have some grand ideas at the beginning of the month. Forget it. It's not going to work. I know what absolutely worked for me was that when I tracked everything using like MyFitnessPal or Lose It or whatever, and I'd add up the calories as I was eating, it would give me clarity. And it was that clarity that helped me with all those individual choices that we have to make on a daily basis. It's all those micro choices throughout the day, throughout the month, that adds up. If you want to know, how does a family spend $800-$900 at the grocery store? It doesn't happen overnight. It happens throughout the course of the month. It's all those individual choices of what you put in the cart. And I agree with you. The only way I feel, or at least the most effective way, that you can assure yourself that you'll stay within a budget is you just have to set parameters on that daily activity. And that's what proactive budget has done. And can you explain a little bit more about how it actually works?
Yes, absolutely. You know, in going into a little bit clarifying what you've said or to further prove that, the average American spends about $1,500 a month in discretionary spending. And this is really where they get in trouble. And we have proven by utilizing proactive, because it's always with them, that they will spend $400 less a month, Josh. $400. Now, $400 a month is $4,800, almost $5,000 a year. $5,000 a year put into the right financial plan will absolutely transform someone's finances over the course of their life. The magic of this whole process is actually this debit card, okay? This debit card is connected to a default zero checking account. That checking account can't overdraft, and there's certain steps that must be taken before you can access the money. So let me kind of walk you through that. So when you set up an account with Proactive, you connect it to your bank, and each month you'll transfer the discretionary income, the discretionary spending money, over to this system, which is simply residing with an FDIC insured bank. And so forth. So when that's transferred in, it comes into what we call undistributed. In the undistributed category, that money cannot be spent until it's first assigned a responsibility. Okay, even in the cash envelope system, if you take cash out of the bank, really you don't have to put it in the envelopes to spend it. And sometimes people, as they use it more, they get lazy and they don't do that, right? But in our system, it requires you to put it into an envelope that you actually create yourself. And once you distribute it, and that's simply the push of a button that creates that distribution, it comes into your envelopes, okay? And you can see our envelopes. We have fuel, Shane fund money, groceries, family trip, Carissa's fund money, date night, so forth, okay? And we have budgeted money for each of those areas. When you distribute, it distributes hard cash. That's what represents the dark green and the dollar amount in the black. And so now we have money in our budget, and when we go to the store, all we have to do is simply push spend. So let's say Chris and I are on a date night, we're going out to eat, and we want to access that $71.42, and we're out there at the restaurant. All I do is push spend, and in about 10 seconds, that money transfers from our checking account to the default zero checking account and becomes available for us to spend. And that's all that's happening. And once that spend takes place, so now it's ready to spend, when I swipe the card, which again, you can see that $71.42 shows up on the debit card.
Yep.
If I try to spend $72, it won't allow me to.
Wow.
I'll have to go back to my budget. I'll have to transfer money from, say, car insurance. No, that's a bad one because we need that.
Don't do that.
Anyways, from a different category so that I have sufficient money, and then I would have to push spend again so that there was at least that amount. Otherwise, the card will decline. And if I don't push spend, Josh, the card will decline because there's no money on the card.
Yeah.
And so it actually causes me each time to go to my budget really simply, look at where I'm at, push the spend button, and as soon as that spend happens, if we had a little more time, I'd show you how I've connected this up to Apple Pay, Walmart Pay, all these things. And then, so when you sign up for our app, you actually get the card within seconds, the virtual card that can be used immediately, connected up to Apple Pay and all those things. And then within 7 days of subscribing, you'll get a physical card that matches the number on the card, and everything syncs together. And as soon as I make that spend, whatever I didn't spend transfers back into the envelope and portrays how much money I have left over in that budgeted category.
I love it. So Shane, how does someone get started with this? Is there a cost associated with it? And how does that part work? How does someone activate a Proactive Budget membership?
Simply by going to the App Store, search Proactive Budget, pulls us up, download the app. Through that process, you are setting up a bank account. So there are some disclaimers and some things that you have to agree to with our bank so that all that is legal and to code. And so you'll take a picture of your driver's license so we get that information. But it's a simple process. And then once you're finished with onboarding to the app, it'll connect your bank account with Proactive. And there'll be a microcredit sent so that all that system is set up and makes it, it's actually really simple. It does take a couple of days because of the microcredit and so forth. But once that's done, when you transfer the money from your account to this, it takes 24 hours. And as soon as you distribute it to the categories, it's immediately available with the click of a button.
Okay. You know, I like this because it actually makes I like the idea of allocating money to certain places. It helps with security as well.
Yeah, let me actually talk about a few other things that we've thought a lot about this and how this could really help people. One is you're right. This is the safest card on the planet because if you don't have any money, if you haven't pushed the spend button, there's no money on the card. So if you lose the card, they get a piece of plastic, right? They'd have to steal your phone, hack into the phone, hack into the app. So it really is the safest card. And I know that, you know, identity theft and security is a big issue in our world today. But in addition to that, we've created a system so it will work as a family. Your children can have cards, okay? They can share in the family budget and have their own envelope system. So for example, if your daughter's at the grocery store, but at volleyball practice, you need her to stop and get some stuff, you can transfer that grocery budget to her. She can use her card, spend, and it sinks all into the family budget. Okay, so there's a lot of cool things. And then husband and wife, in each envelope, if you look over the details, you can set up controls of how much money can be spent without authorization from the spouse. And all these are all optional, you know, but they're all available so that you can work as husband and wife. Wow. In your family budget. Because it's interesting that in most situations, one is a good budgeter and one's not. Consequently, 2/3 of the arguments in marriage are over finances. Okay. Yeah. So you asked about price, Josh. And so for one card, it's $69 a year. Okay. So incredibly reasonable for companion cards, husband and wife cards. It's $98 a year. We haven't built out the kid card yet. We are doing that currently. It'll be available early next year, and each kid card will be $20. For a husband and wife, it's just under $100 to have a budgeting system that they can work together, and we have proven that they will spend $400 less a month by utilizing this system. Like you said, just like with the diet, it's always in front of them.
Yeah.
There's tracking. There's proof. Everything's real.
Yeah. You know, we have to be honest with ourselves, Shane. And I believe in setting up systems that make things easy and automatic. You know, it's why Dave Ramsey advocated the envelope system, you know, over a decade ago, because it works. It's the only thing that truly, truly works, because human behavior is set up so that we want something, and it can be really, really easy to just kind of forget about it. We get to the end, we do a post-mortem budget, and we're always frustrated with the fact that we can't stay on a budget. Think of the family fights that can be avoided if you could actually work together as husband and wife and have a successful budget together month after month after month. You could just, that's why I like the name Proactive, because that's exactly what you're doing, is you're being very proactive on exactly how the money is being delegated. And so if you're in an emergency situation, you can do what you have to do, but at least we can make sure to curb that, what'd you call it, discretionary spending, right?
Yeah, that's right. That's exactly right. You know, and Josh, this is actually very emotional for Ryan and I, because literally through this experience, both he and I in our marriages have faced difficult financial periods where it has caused a lot of stress and a lot of frustration. And we see and feel that with clients, hundreds of clients. And we see Proactive as a tool, as a platform where millions of families can be lifted from the paycheck to paycheck cycle that causes so much stress in marriage and family and work and everything, and then help them eliminate debt permanently. And we have some things coming with the automated debt elimination system that we will be building out that will connect right in with the budgeting system. So anyways, we really feel like this can be an answer to millions of families, and we are passionate about that. So anyways, it really is exciting to us too, Josh.
Yeah. Well, I've checked out Proactive Budget app, and it's a no-brainer to me. So this video, you know, for those who are the benefit of listening to us in our podcast app, we have a post. We have a video with Shane and I where it kind of shows you some of the screenshots from the phone itself. We'll include more information in the post just in regards to the reasons why we believe at Savings Angel that the Proactive app, honestly, I've played with a lot of apps over the past 11 plus years and even before then. This, honestly, in my experience, is the only thing that I think will truly, truly work for the vast majority of us, just because, you know, we set those parameters. And those parameters are available to us on a daily basis as opposed to just guessing from day to day. So I love it. Shane, thank you so much for being a part, you and Ryan, in creating the Proactive Budgeting app. Again, it's available on the App Store, in the Apple App Store. Google Android, is that in the pipeline?
It is. That will be released the first of next year. And if you reach out to us through our website, which is proactivebudget.com, we can connect you in with actually some instructions where you can utilize it now through a hack, actually.
Yeah, right, web-based browser or something.
But it'll be available early next year.
Sounds good. All right. So Shane Walker, thank you so much for joining us with Proactive Budget. And again, go to savingsangel.com if you're listening to this. Look for the post. We'll have it in the sidebar, actually, throughout the website, where we talk about our review of the Proactive Budgeting app, and then we'll give you some suggestions on best ways to use it. And above all, you know, how you and your loved ones can get on the same page. You don't have to fight about money anymore. You can just work together, set up a system that's going to work for you. Shane, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you, Josh. I really appreciate it. Thanks for being such an advocate to us.
Now, if you've loved hearing everything in this podcast, would you take a second and leave a 5-star review in iTunes? By doing so, you help us get this podcast out to more people. The higher a rating, the more we're noticed. And honestly, sharing this with a friend really helps share this message of abundance. I promise I'm going to make you look good. I'm going to work as hard as I have for the past 230. What are we up to? Yeah, this is episode 232. So these 232 episodes, we're going to make you look good. We're going to do a lot of good in the world together by you just sharing it with a friend. So as always, if you have any specific questions, anything you'd like to hear me talk about, you could drop me a comment in the podcast feedback. Write to me on our private Facebook group. Just search Savings Angel in Facebook. Join our Facebook group. Love to have you. You can call the podcast hotline right now at 407-205-9250 and leave me a message. I'm going to answer your question, write you back, or with your permission, I might even share your question or story with others on the show. With that, have a wonderful week full of saving more, earning more, and living more abundantly. And thank you for listening. Money, like a lot of free money, like a lot of money that's like free.